If we can create a world that is sustainable, prosperous, and a harmonious place to live, what on earth are we going to do with ourselves? Surely by continuing to change our environment, we too will need to adapt, upgrade. Once all our worldly problems are eradicated, where then will our curiosity to continuously improve ourselves take us? Immortality, perhaps. I recently reread one of my favorite books by Yuval Noah Harari called Homo Deus, and instantly I was driven to look even deeper into the future prospects of the human species. And you guessed it, you're coming along with me. This is Dynamic Science, and today we're going to investigate a few scenarios of how technology may affect the evolution of the human species. Up until the 20th century, humans did not have an easy run, to put it nicely. Many things we take for granted today were a daily struggle. However, if you were to go back in time, there were three main problems that you would be confronted with: famine, plague, and war. The possibility of death was always lingering around the corner. Throughout history, over and over again, large populations had their lives cut short. If the human species does make it another 1,000 years, with technology evolving exponentially, it is safe to say the world is going to look very different. The set of some now science fiction movie. Potentially very beautiful if we go about it correctly. For now though, let's just grab some popcorn and enjoy watching it all play out. So, what's next? As the most intelligent species, and putting morals aside for a moment, what could our next big leap be? With our higher cognitive abilities, we can now quite literally manipulate evolution and write our own story before it has even happened. One very real possibility is upgrading ourselves into superhumans, creating a new godlike fraction of the human species. You may think this concept is new. However, you just have to look at how much science and technology is currently dedicated to prolonging life within healthcare to realize it is not. We are busy finding ways to overcome old age and all the daily ailments and suffering, ultimately trying to acquire control of our own biological stratum. The question is no longer if or when, but how. Will humanity upgrade or hack our own evolution? And it is looking like it comes down to one of these three very real possibilities. Biological engineering. Bioengineering is a field that combines the knowledge of physics, math, chemistry, and biology to solve everyday problems. A particular field under this deals with the biological functions of living organisms. And, with a few amazing man-made tools, allows us to alter its genetic code. A fictitious example would be Hulk from the Marvel Universe. He is biologically engineered and he is damn cool. In the last 4 billion years, life paved its way from the simplest nucleoids to the most complex sapiens. Evolution has its magic. However, bioengineers won't wait patiently for natural selection to drive life anymore. They have already taken control of the steering wheel through the use of CRISPR, a gene editing tool that works like a pair of chemical scissors, capable of cutting strands of DNA, allowing bioengineers to remove, replace, or add whatever they like. And boy, are they already doing wonders with it. For instance, organs, like the heart and lung in a human, are the same size in a pig. So recently, one company, eGenesis, began using CRISPR to snip out a family of viruses found in pig DNA to make the pigs suitable organ donors for humans. Also, we can detect specific targets, such as DNA from cancer-causing viruses and RNA from cancer cells, using the same genome editing method. Such research on humans is still highly restricted for now, but in the future, with more tools and technology evolving exponentially, bioengineers one day may be able to enhance human DNA and even grow new desired bodily structures. Shotgun wings. Cyborg engineering. A cyborg, or a cybernetic organism, is a living being that consists of organic and non-organic body parts. It is a part machine, part human hybrid of neurons and wires which act as a seamless interface between a human and a computer. Nebula in Marvel's Infinity Wars would be a perfect fictitious example of a cyborg. However, we don't actually need a fictitious example, as humans have made great progress in this field. The finest example would be that of Neil Harbison, a British-Irish artist, and the first person to ever be legally recognized as a cyborg. He was born colorblind and now has an antenna implanted in his skull to convert color frequencies into sound, which in turn helps him see better. Okay, that's frickin' cool. We can already connect non-organic devices like these directly to our brains to control bionic body parts. This technology is currently being used to provide bionic man-made body parts to people with disabilities, and in the future this same tech will be used to create stronger, more abled human beings. Scientists are suggesting the development of cyborg avatar doctors that can perform emergency surgeries in Italy, India, and a space station on Mars at the same time without the human doctor ever leaving their clinic, all with the help of a few extra bionic eyes and hands. Which might sound like an exaggeration, but so did much of the tech we now take for granted before it became an essential part of our everyday life. Engineering of non-organic beings. Although this third path is jumping into the distant future, if immortality is truly our deepest desire, this road is the best option. Life in non-organic compounds is all about transferring the consciousness of a living being into non-living structures. After 4 billion years of wandering in the kingdoms of organic compounds, life will break out into the vastness of the non-organic realm, taking any shape that is desired, which is still quite the unfathomable future. Thankfully, we're still very much taking our first steps towards this technology. If the human species does make it another 1,000 years, with technology evolving exponentially, it is safe to say the world is going to look very different, the set of some now science fiction movie. Potentially very beautiful if we go about it correctly. For now though, let's just grab some popcorn and enjoy watching it all play out. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for your weekly dose of dynamic science.